about your age. I made the decision when I was about 15. The way I came to it was I was good in sports and track and field and played ball and stuff. And I came across a drawing by Leonardo da Vinci. He was a really old guy, long hair. He looked like he was 90 or 100 years old. I thought, I don't know any old sports guys. But this guy obviously could do it all his life. So I decided when I was 15, that's what I wanted to do.
Wow.
And it turned out he wasn't his age. He's only 65. I'm very close to that age now. I'm in much better shape than he was. I went to elementary schools and high school and a little bit of art college. My mom was an artist, so I used to go, she'd go out painting and I'd take my charcoal. And I started that way, and then I was about 12 when I did my first oil painting. So I started painting very young. When I was in high school, I took a lot of extra time in the art class. I skipped some classes because I could do those pretty well in my classes anyway, so if I could take time, I would spend time in art classes. My mom had a ceramic studio, so I did a lot of decorations, stuff like that. So I was always, made a lot of pottery and stuff, so I always was able to do some art stuff.
Does drawing and painting come naturally to you, or did you have to learn?
I think every kid has a natural artistic ability, and I like to collect kids' paintings and study them because kids pick colors. They naturally compose things. Whatever's important to them, like they might not have hands, they might have big heads, and you know, whoever's the most important person, they'll be really big, and their mood shows up. And if there's a big blank space here, they'll put some kind of crazy color or something there that will balance the whole thing. As they get older, they lose this natural ability, and they try to do more realistic things, which is okay so long as you don't lose those things that you have. And what artists do is they just have they manage to do things in a natural way. They keep that ability to look at things and feel things. My mom. I mean, there was painting around all the time. And there's a lot of other artists. You know, I like Leonardo da Vinci. We lived just outside of Washington, D.C., so we went down to the galleries there. There was Monet. There was a painting that I always liked was, there's a matador that died. And it's a huge painting. And it always struck me when I was young. And my mom took me also when I was pretty young to Van Gogh exhibit. It was an extensive exhibit, and it's very rare to see that much Van Gogh. So that kind of stuff, and I really liked his stuff. I had really good high school art teachers, and I worked with a guy named David Brown. When I was 15, I started life drawing lessons, which I guess was young. And it was like painting. I missed the drawing part. So that was pretty good, and then I worked with him on some backdrops for Hello Dolly stuff in high school, and so I learned how to work large scale.
What is your favorite mural that you painted?
That I painted? I have two. There's one downtown, and the window is missing on it. It's called Swinging to the Music. And it's a history of the music. North End of Lexington. It was a real fun mural. The people I researched and talked to were very, they invited me to their homes. I shared their photographs. They let me take them for a day while I made copies. They didn't know who the heck I was. It's an Afro-American neighborhood, so I was kind of like a peculiar guy walking in and knocking on their door and telling them what I want. But they were extremely gracious. And we had a nice party for the unveiling of the mural, and they had dancers. It was a great fun. We managed to get two guys. One was a brother of one of the guys in the mural. The other one was a local architect that wrote a book, Jazz in Lexington, and 80s, and he played, and he gave me a lot of information about his book, and that was a lot of fun. And then in Georgetown at Southern Elementary, I have a huge, huge mural with kids from around the world. It goes from about 7 foot to about 14 foot. It's a big rotunda. It's about 145 foot long. You have to look up at it. And it's kids from around the world. And that was a 7-month mural. It was very interesting. Learning about the different kids. We put different buildings in there and animals and plants. And it's an international school. They interface with kids from different countries. And do like a, what is that? Kind of like Skype, but a little bit better. And so that was a very interesting mural. And what was nice about it, or different about it, was that living here, basically you have one palette for people's skin colors. But when you do people from around the world, there's very few light-skinned people. Mm-hmm. Most of them are multicolored of skins. Tones and bone structures, and that was extremely interesting and very cool. Different types of dress, the way they dressed. Kids in South America that were up in the mountains. Different types of Oriental people, Europeans. It was just a lot of fun.
What was your first
one? What was my first one? I had that when I was in high school. I don't know if it was my first or second year. I had this crazy doodle, and I did an 8-foot by 8-foot mural of some kind of weird bird thing. I don't remember what it looks like exactly now. I don't think I recorded it. I didn't take a painting of it. I did that when I was at Loyalist Collegiate Vocational Institute in Canada. And then I did, I guess after that, the closest thing to a mural was the 20-foot backdrop for Hello Dolly, which is Yonkers train station.
Wow.
We did that chart. That was kind of neat. We laid it out and we snapped grid lines for every 2 foot, and then 2 foot this way, 2 foot squares. And we had this drawing, and we had it drawn out. We did, hung it up, did a piece of scaffold. And we used charcoal and just drew it on. So you drew each square, and when you got back, it was together. It was magic. It was very abstract. And then when I first came to town here, I walked in the wrong building, and one thing led to another, and I started doing billboards. So I painted billboards for quite a few years. I painted liquor bottles, and airplanes, and pickles, and bread, fruit, celebrity, pickles, Paramount pickles. Pickles on a plate, pickles behind glass in the jar, so it's very different to do that. And furniture, and celebrities. I did a lot of celebrities like Lee Greenwood. They had a country western station here. So I painted a lot of Willie Nelson, Exile, Oak Ridge Boys, Barbara Mendrell, Dolly Parton. And they were big portraits. They were at least 14, when a single portrait would be 14 foot high. Some of the portraits were as big as, I did an Arnold Palmer, that was 20 foot high portrait. He came and we had a senior PGA tournament here, just old guys playing golf. And he came and signed the artwork for me in front of the billboard, so it was kind of fun.
You got one more right? Okay,
and I can't golf worth beans, but I don't even care. If you draw and you do real well, what I find is, I've had some kids come over and I've given them little lessons and stuff like that. I had one guy that I haven't seen him in years. He used to live in my neighborhood, and I completely forgot about it. He talked about, he does some creative stuff now, he's not an artist, but he remembered coming over and me showing him stuff, and I completely forgot. It took me to look a couple hours later and go, oh, I remember now. But usually what happens is, I'll know some people that I know, and I'll offer to mentor, or you know, they come out and I'll offer, if I see someone with talent, I'll make an offer. I'll do it two or three times. And what happens is, when you guys get into your teens, you don't know what to do with that. You won't take it up. Sometimes when you get in your 20s, it'll finally, even then, you'll be too shy to take advantage of someone that will offer to mentor you. And I had great people that mentored me. I said, okay. I jumped on every opportunity that I had, and I met some wonderful artists, and I learned a lot from each and every one of them. And artist comes from a tradition. People that artists before you that you learn from, and then you stand on their shoulders and you create art that's your own. But the only way to get there is from help from other people, different perspectives. You don't have to do all everything they said. I mean, you can try some things. It's like I've had guys that I've taught that were very good, and I say, okay, I want you to put all your knowledge in this suitcase. We're opening a new suitcase over here, and I'm going to help you pack for a new trip. If you'll let me. And it's very hard. I get a lot of questions and stubbornness and all kinds of stuff, but eventually I wear them down and I say, they keep wanting to open their suitcase. No, we're leaving this closed. We're getting this new stuff we're going to use. And they closed it up, and eventually, even the most hard-headed of the guys I'll hear them later, and it's like a recording. They're saying the things. They fight a lot, but they're listening. There's nothing wrong with fighting so long as you let something go in your head. If you're fighting it, then you're thinking about it. Some people just absorb it all. So I would say just be open to listening to different things. And once you think you've got it all, put the suitcase, put yourself in something that you don't know, something that's new, maybe a different, you know, if you're watercolors, you say, okay, I'm putting my watercolors away, let's try clay, let's try oil painting, let's try collage. You just put that stuff away so that you can learn something new. People know a lot of stuff, so you can be open to new ideas. And when someone offers, say, okay, don't be so shy, because they're seeing, that means they see something in you that they think they can help bring in. But it's weird sometimes when an adult offers to do that. I guess, especially when you're a teenager, it's tricky to do. I mean, I've done that, and usually they turn out, they come around, but sometimes they're 24, 25 years old, and they wasted a lot of time.